Hello everyone, welcome to this session on cybersecurity. So far we have covered three modules. So in the third module, we have seen the following things. Proliferation of mobile and wireless devices, different trends in mobility, different credit card frauds, and different security challenges posed by mobile devices, and different attacks on mobile or cell phones. We have seen mobile phone theft, phishing, and all these things. And then we have seen mobile devices, security implications for organizations, as well as organizational measures for handling mobiles. And finally, we have seen some safety measures for laptops. So that's about what has been covered in module or unit 3. So now we will look at module 4. So the module 4 is titled as Tools and Methods Used in Cybercrime. So the things we are going to look at in this module are like this. So first of all, we will look at some introduction, followed by something about proxy servers and anonymizers, followed by a technique called phishing. After that, we will look at password cracking, and then we will discuss about keyloggers and spywares. Then we will look at virus and worms, followed by Trojan horses and backdoors. And then we will look at a method called steganography, and we will look at a popular type of attack called DOS and DDoS. And then we will look at another technique called SQL injection, followed by another technique called buffer overflow. And then we will look at some of the attacks that can be performed on wireless networks. And then we will see phishing in detail. And finally, we will conclude the module 4 with identity theft. So there are a lot of things that will be covered in this module 4. So follow carefully. And let's start module 4. So, like we have already discussed in module 2, the basic stages in a cyber crime or cyber attack are, first one is these two contribute towards reconnaissance, which is like gathering details. After gathering all the details, then we will perform the actual attack. These three are related to performing the actual attack, and after performing the attack, the attacker will try to cover their tracks, like clearing of the log files and all these things. So that is about basic stages in an attack. And now we will look at some of the important terms that you will come across in cybersecurity. First is scareware. So when you are browsing different web pages in a browser, you will see this kind of messages. So it will say your computer is infected with so and so virus or Trojan or something else, and download this software to clear your system. So never download such kind of software. Those are fake messages. So actually, when you download that software, you will your system will get infected with a Trojan or virus. So always ignore such kind of warnings. And next one is malvertising. So different people across the internet will publish advertisements, either through Google AdSense or many other networks. They will publish their business through advertisements. So some of the malicious people, what they will do is they will publish virus and worms or Trojans as an advertisement. Okay, so when you browse a website and you see an advertisement and click that advertisement to download software, your system will get infected. Okay, so this is called malvertising. And then another thing is clickjacking. So maybe on Facebook or Twitter or some other Instagram, you might find some advertisements or links for a particular service. Okay. So when you click that link, you will be redirected to some web page. Okay, like a, let's say, survey page or something else, which will ask your information, your first name, last name, address, your email ID, your mobile number, etc., etc. So actually, this page will be controlled by an attacker. Okay, so once you fill your information on this web page, that data will go to attacker. And the attacker can later use that information for different kinds of frauds, financial frauds or some other fraud. Okay. And last one is ransomware. So this is a kind of malware which will enter your system through different ways. And generally what it will do is it will lock or encrypt all of your files on your system. Okay. So it basically makes your system unusable. You can't use anything on your system. To unlock the files, the attacker will ask you to send some money. So in this example, they are asking $300 to send as bitcoins. And this is the Bitcoin wallet ID, attacker's Bitcoin wallet ID. So when you make this payment, you will get the decryption key. Okay, sometimes even if you pay the ransom, you will not get the key. Okay, so that is about ransomware. So these are the different important or key terms that you will come across in cybersecurity. And next, we are going to look at proxy servers and anonymizers. So what is a proxy server is? It's another computer or system or a device on the network which comes in between your system and the internet. Okay, so it is like this. So this is your system and this is the internet, okay, and in between comes the proxy server. Okay, so originally if you don't use proxy server, the traffic, the internet traffic goes directly to the next hub or next device. Okay, generally it will be router or the ISP related device. Okay, all right. And if you use proxy, the traffic will go to the proxy, and then from the proxy server, it will go to the next main system. Okay, in the network. So what is the use of this proxy is, you can see here, some of the users are, it can be used for caching the content, and it can be used for filtering. Okay, I will explain in the coming slides what is this. And also it can be used to hide your original identity. For example, the IP address of your system is 1.1.1.1. And the IP address of proxy server is 2.2.2.2. For example, let's say the destination is Facebook. Okay, facebook.com. So when you are using proxy server or browsing the internet to proxy server, what will Facebook see is, Facebook will see the IP address 2.2.2.2 instead of your IP address. Okay, so this is, so you can use proxy server for anonymous browsing. You can hide your original identity and give the identity of proxy to the destination or target. Okay, right. So this is a typical setting in a company or office. So in a company or office, there will be multiple systems, multiple user systems, which will be connected to a device called switch. And this switch will be connected to the proxy server. Okay. And this proxy server will be connected to the internet router or modem. And finally, this router will be connected to internet. Okay, so for example, here you are visiting Facebook again, like in the previous example. Now Facebook will see the IP address of proxy server. For example, this is 2.2.2.2. Okay, and let's say you are browsing Facebook from this system 1.1.1.1. Now Facebook will see the IP address, this one. Okay, so it's a sort of anonymous browsing. And now let's see the what is the purpose of using proxy server. So first one is hide company servers or systems. So typically in companies or education institutions or whatever organizations you take, they will use a proxy server to which all other systems in the organization will be connected to. So the outside world, outside the organization, they will only see the proxy server which belongs to the organization. They can't directly access the user systems. Okay, so that is this hide company servers or systems. And another example, like I have previously said, is caching. So the frequently accessible content or frequently accessed content is temporarily stored in the proxy. So whenever the user systems are requesting a web page again and again, only first time it is fetched from the internet, from the next time onwards it is accessed directly from the proxy server to make it fast. And next one is filter unwanted content. For example, if you want to filter ads like Google AdSense ads and other kinds of ads, you can do that in the proxy server. Okay, not only that, if you want to block some websites like adult websites or Facebook or Instagram or Twitter and all these things, you can filter them out at the proxy. And then proxy can act as IP address multiplexer. So in IP there is a feature called NAT, network address translation. So that is this that comes as this IP address multiplexer. So the outside world will only look at only one IP address. That IP address belongs to the proxy server. So at the proxy server there is some address translation taking place. So if you want further details, look at something called NAT, network address translation. So when you read this, you will get the idea what is this IP address multiplexing. Okay, and then anonymizer. So it's an anonymous proxy which allows the user to browse internet anonymously. Okay, so you can say anonymizer is a special case of proxy server, and it is generally used by crackers for covering their tracks. So if you don't want the target to see your IP address, you will browse through a proxy. So different types of proxies, there are three types. One is transparent proxy, another one is anonymous proxy, and the last one is elite proxy. So look at this table. So if it is transparent proxy, the target can know you are using a proxy. Okay, and the target can trace your real IP address also. Okay, so if the target is able to trace the real IP address, there is no anonymity. Yes? Okay. Now, if you are using anonymous proxy, the target will know that you are using a proxy, but they will not be able to trace your real IP address. Okay? They can see the proxy IP address, but they can't trace your real IP address. Since they can't trace your real IP address, you can say it is anonymous. And last one is elite. So elite is very powerful, or you can say beautiful. So the target does not know that you are using a proxy, and also they can't trace your real IP address, and this is perfect anonymity. Okay, so whenever you want to hide your tracks, you have to use elite proxies. Okay, so these are some examples of proxy software, very famous ones in Nginx, Tor, Squid, and UltraSurf. So in the last decade, Tor has become very popular. So I want to spend some time to explain about Tor. Okay, so in between you have the Tor network. Okay, so TAR network is a collection of systems which are run by normal people. Okay, so these systems does not belong to any organization. They are run by normal people like you and me. Okay, if you want your system to become a part of TAR network, you can register in the TAR network. Okay, right. So first of all, consider that there is no TAR network and you are not using TAR. So let's assume this is your system. Okay, so when you are not using TAR network, so you are directly communicating with the internet like this. Okay, information goes to internet and information comes back from internet to you. Okay, now consider that you are using TAR network. So for using TAR network, you have to download the TAR software and install on your system. Okay, once you install the TAR network and you want to access some website, what will happen is triple encryption. Okay, so encrypt once, encrypt second time, twice, encrypt third time, thrice. Okay, so your data is encrypted three times. And now the data which is encrypted three times will go to TAR network. Okay, now what will TAR software do is it will select three systems. So in this case, it is selecting system 1, system 2, system 3. Okay, so this is the entry node and this is the exit node. Okay, so your triple encrypted data goes to this system. So the outer layer will be torn off, it will be removed. Okay, so double encrypted data will go to the next system. Again, second layer will be removed, and then the single encrypted data will be sent to the last node where the last layer will be taken off. Now what you can see from here is this exit node can see the real data which you are sending from here. Okay, so this node can't see the real data and the second node cannot also see the original data. So the exit node, which will remove the final layer of encryption, it can see the original data and then it will forward to the internet. So this is how TAR software works, TAR software and TAR network works. Okay, right. And I would like to explain the differences between TAR and VPN. So VPN means virtual private network. It is another option for providing or gaining anonymity, anonymous browsing. So when you have to choose between TAR and VPN, how can you choose this? By looking at these things. Okay, so let's see. So when you consider speed, okay, VPN is faster than TAR. So you can guess why TAR is slow, because of the triple encryption and decryption. Because of that, it is slow. And next, compatibility with all devices like desktops, laptops, mobile phones, tablets. VPN is more portable or compatible with all the devices than TAR. TAR is not available for iOS and some special kinds of operating systems. And next one is peer-to-peer file sharing, like for example torrents. Okay, for such kind of applications, VPN is more faster than TAR. And if you want complete anonymity, TAR is best when compared to VPN. So why TAR is more preferable than VPN is because of the triple encryption. Okay, and next, protects all online connections. For this feature, VPN is suitable than TAR. And last, price. With respect to price, VPN, there are free services and TAR is already free, it is not paid. So both are okay. And easiness to set up and use, both are very easy to set up and use, no problem. And if you want to access the support team or support, VPN is more better than TAR, because TAR is public, it doesn't provide any support, whereas VPN is there is free versions of VPN as well as commercial So if you purchase commercial VPN, you will get access to support. So if you have any problems, the people will solve your problems. Okay. So if you want to try out in Kali Linux, so both of these things are already available in Kali Linux. So there is something called proxy chain in Kali Linux as well as AnonServe. These are softwares which you can use in Kali Linux. So both of these things use Tor network automatically. So if you want, you can see some tutorials on YouTube, and you can use this either proxy chains or AnonServe. Okay. So that's it about introduction and proxy servers and anonymizers. Thank you.